Virtual reality is very useful in science and in complex things, but it also has a role to play in simple things such as the most mundane business tasks, I believe, can be used for, you can use virtual reality to gain insights. At the Idaho National Laboratory, we started doing virtual reality in 2009. Our first system was a cave that was planned to be deployed in the summertime. In order to prepare for the cave, we chose to bring some content, to get some content ready through the use of a portable cave. That experience gave us great exposure to experts, to the processes, to the technologies, and most importantly, it gave us a working model of one of our nuclear reactor facilities.
Duke University is working on the blended reality space, from augmented reality to virtual reality, to really set a stepping stone of what is going to be the path or the roadmap to the education of the future. These kind of technologies are going to impact all industries, but of course, depending on the industry, we will see bigger or smaller impacts. In general, where this is going to happen first is in those industries delivering services and complex services. Education is one of those, for example. All the health industry is going to be heavily affected by this kind of technology.
At Case Western Reserve University, we've partnered with Cleveland Clinic in order to use augmented reality for our new health education campus. This health education campus will house the schools of medicine, dental, nursing, and the Cleveland Clinic School of Learner Medicine, all in one building, really putting the disciplines together for one of the first times in education. And this building is almost 500,000 square feet. And so we are really looking at the state of the future here. And we decided not to put in cadaver labs to teach anatomy. We wanted to do something very new and very different. So we were introduced to HoloLens from Microsoft in November of 2014. My expectations for that technology, seeing it at first, were very low. I had done some other virtual reality and some mixed reality, and I just didn't think it would work. And I went through the first demo that Microsoft did with us. This was very, very early. It was still tethered. It still had all kinds of wires going through your head. But my first reaction was, you just changed my life. I came out of the first demo and told them, you just changed my life. This is technology I did not think I would ever see in my lifetime, let alone my professional lifetime.
Virtual reality right now is helping users analyze multidimensional data at the laboratory. One example of this sort of data is electric vehicle charging information relative to your electric vehicle, where it parks, how it charges, where it charges. That data set that actually contains your electric vehicle charging information is multidimensional. It has maybe up to 20 dimensions of data embedded in each point. Using virtual reality, using a 3D display, allows our researchers to display up to, right now they're displaying 10 dimensions of data concurrently, giving you insights into that electric vehicle, the behavior of the driver, and the things that you can do to optimize the charging infrastructure.
We got really interested in how can we use this in this new health education campus, and have been exploring with Microsoft since early 2015, really, is when we started the technology development in order to be able to teach anatomy in a whole different way. And with 3D and augmented reality, which means I can see you too, I'm not just in some world of my own, it has really brought to light a new way of learning for our students.